Alrighty then, good afternoon everybody, Silver Dragon here, finally coming at you with some more Clockwork Empires, and I do apologize, it has been quite a few days since I last did an episode on this, and like I said last time, I did actually let a little bit of time go by so we could get some general production done. Now, not much time has gone by, mostly because something I didn't expect to happen, well, happened. The Grimoire actually got translated. Now, this is the first time that I've allowed the priest to try and deal with the Grimoire, and something is, you know, it's other than it being lost has happened. So I was like, oh hell, that's awesome. Also, some more Stelmarkian pals showed up here, and will be dropping off a lot of stuff that I want to buy, so I figured, hey, that's a good excuse as well. So we're going to continue on from here. So the Grimoire was translated, shockingly. Things in that book, they're terrible things, and it is an abomination. We should burn this book at once. Just to see what happens, I'm going to say no. I'm going to allow the Grimoire to exist, the new science. Royal Society. Even if you're not personally reaped the rewards, whatever unnatural knowledge dwells in the pages, sure that he will make it good use. So it gave us 5 standing since we didn't have anybody available to take it. So that's not bad, but you know, this still kind of sucks a little bit. Ooh, I'm gonna buy those steel ingots. Still gotta wait for them to actually, you know, arrive entirely. And I want to make sure they're not attacked by anything along the way, because if they are, then that's really going to suck. Oh, now they're deciding to turn around. Call the Vika, or the Vicar. Yes, the Vicar! Of course, everyone's still kind of going really, really slow. Although, this only actually started when I started recording, so it's definitely part of what's causing the lag. Not that my computer is actually having any real difficulty running the game, but still, for whatever reason, it's having some slowdown. Some of the slowdown is caused by that. Alright, let's get some trading done here now, just in case they decide to try and run away. I want to make sure to buy everything they've got. I'm not going to, well, not everything they got. I don't want to buy their beer. I have no interest in their beer. Let's buy some brass. Why not? But I definitely want all of their copper plates. Every single one of their copper plates. Let's also buy all their opium. I don't care for the beer. I already have beer. I make that myself. Don't need none of that junk. Got my wine. I actually sell one of my carbine lockers because I am going to build the laudanum lockers, finally. So let's sell both of those. I'm not selling my rare paintings. Oh, good. We have a lot of copper pipes and plates. That's good. We'll be adding more to that here now. We have a pretty decent amount of iron ingots. I'm just waiting for that one machine. Also, I should really lathe some iron pipes as well. Where's my gold bars? Did I miss my gold bars? Am I being blind? I am being blind. Here it is right there. Let's sell a couple of these to make up the difference. Good enough. Simply appalling trade deal. Okay. What, do you want more money? Apparently you want a lot more money. I'm gonna try removing the carbines. Pleasure doing business with you. Cog, save the jolly old queen and all that. Pip, pip. So, I really do hope this guy with the steel ingots does show up, though. Looks like we have more plates, as well as, of course, the guy holding the copper pipes. I hope he actually makes it as well. But worst comes to worst, he doesn't. Now let's actually activate the lathe. Let me pause here. I still have not built the stamper, so oh well. Also, I realized the reason why we weren't producing any gunpowder was it actually requires charcoal, which I don't have. Not coal, but charcoal. So we are now producing that as I rebuilt the charcoal producing workshop there. Workbench. Yeah, 20 ingots into 10 pipes. We have 40 ingots, so that'll be fine. And if I get the chance, we will use this stamper here to produce, 10, what the hell. Come on, buddy, get over there. Something tells me he's not gonna make it. He's not gonna make it, man! Nope. But hey, at least I will actually manage to get the steel here, because I'll take all the steel I can get. Also, we have a lovely tent here that showed up. Actually, I think that was there last time, but anyway. Oh, you didn't just stop there. Come on. Come on, buddy. That's just mean. That's just mean. Well, hell. Like, where the heck did the other guy go now, suddenly? Apparently he disappeared. Oh, well, that's alright. I guess they'll just leave here eventually. So everything else is progressing now, slowly. We need to get five... Actually, what the hell? Five bits of charcoal, though, before they will produce the... 10 gunpowder. So it's five charcoal, five, what the hell, sulfur for 10 gunpowder. At which point they can then use the, make the unstable catalysts and such. 10 iron pipes was done in the lathe. That was quick and easy. Fantastic. So I'm gonna spare, if they would build that damn stamper. Four steel ingots. It's probably the steel. 90% sure the reason why we aren't making it is because we need the steel. Actually, how's my chalk mine coming along? That's probably part of the issue. Why are you all hauling that here? No. No, you silly wankers. You do not haul that all the way out here for no reason. Whatever. What's like, whatever now. I don't even care anymore. Yeah, I'm really disappointed that they were... that they didn't bring the steel over here. They did bring, eventually bring the additional copper plates... which I guess I'll buy. But the fact that they didn't get the steel ingots... well, we do have enough... we do have a decent amount of steel ingots, so... I don't know why it's a problem. So they really don't like the boxed carbines for some reason. So be it, but it's unfortunate. They love my gold, though, apparently. They just absolutely can't get enough of my gold. But, for whatever reason, they refuse to use the carbines. Alright. Well, he's taking that somewhere. How many have we produced, even? He is making the brass cogs. We've produced two charcoal. Where the hell did he go? Here's one charcoal. So it's still going to be a bit of a hassle to get all this done. I mean, we're doing what we can, but for whatever reason, it's just... can only do so much here. We have enough brass cogs. Like, I don't know why they're not producing that. We have the brass cogs. We should have the steel ingots. Although, it seems like, again, my... yeah, I don't care. Huh, I got two reactive catalysts. My stockpile list could be lying to me. It says we have 10 steel ingots when we try to trade, but I only see one. Because I like to rely on what I can actually see. Two pipes right there, 10 steel pipes there. I mean, there's still a chance that some of it's kind of hidden like this one. But not really sure where. Maybe we have some over here hiding. Got some rough stone blocks back there. But that's all per normal. So, yeah, awkward. Awkward. Wonder where our jolly old aristocrat is. Or have we not gotten him yet? Let me zoom all the way to the bottom here. No, I'm not really sure how to tell. But I'm assuming we haven't got him yet. They haven't even placed this thing. Yeah, to be completely honest, more than likely, once we wrap up the current objectives that I have right now for this, that's probably the last I'm going to be doing on Clockwork Empires for the moment. There's actually a couple of things that I really do want to dive into. But I just don't have enough time to do so. What are you producing right now? In the forge. Why did you put iron ingots in the forge to make brass cogs? Whatever. Let me up the priority on the charcoal here. God knows we have enough of them, that should be fine. So we need three more. Once they produce three more, then hopefully they'll start working on the gunpowder, then we can get other things produced. Should I say to hell with it for the stamper right now? Yeah, let's say to hell with it for the stamper. For whatever reason, they're not doing it, so let's just make two laden rifles. It's gonna cost us an arm and a leg, but you know what? At least that way we don't have to worry about them using up our ammunition anymore. So yeah, we're going to quickly produce two laden rifles and get them put down. Let me actually go into the barracks here and place those rifles. Oh, what a beautiful day. Lovely. Crops will do swimmingly then. And then back to the ye old barracks over here. Wait. Like, what am I trying to place this in right now? Clearly the wrong location. Apparently I need to make three of them. I completely forgot about that one, so let's make three then. That way our military is ridiculous at that point. Honestly, once we get to that point, we don't even need to get the Steam Knight, but I just want to build him to say, you know what? I did it. Let's write some flattery. At least that way it's going to stop bitching at me for having a, what the hell? Full diplomacy points. Alright, looks like... Ooh, stack of five. Where the hell are you going? Oh, you did not just do that. Okay, clearly I need to stop all smelting for now. Let me even stop the brass cogs. Because I need all that damn charcoal for the gunpowder, damn it. Once the gunpowder is made, then we don't have to worry anymore. We can do whatever the hell you want with it. But the fact that they're prioritizing the charcoal over just coal annoys me a little, because it's needed for other products. Arrgh. Again, there's definitely a lot more refinement I can see that could be done with this game, and considering The improvements that they made over time for Dungeons of Dreadmore, I have no doubt that the dev will eventually, you know, refine this game into something nice. But for now, I think I'm going to kind of end it with... Oh good, they did actually make a batch. Fantastic. I want them to keep making more though, because we need a lot for this. Let me actually cancel that even, because I really want you guys only working on that. Uh-oh. He discovered another grimoire! Lovely! Dear lord, we are finding grimoires everywhere. Are we still exploring the Stygian Abyss? No, we are no longer exploring the Stygian Abyss. Yeah, I'm gonna switch them back to the shallow. That way we actually get a good batch of everything. Oh no, run away! What is it, the bandits again? I do hope they work on that. I mean, we have everything we need for that. More than enough glass. More than enough planks and iron pipes. And copper plates, of course. Oh good, he's making it now. Excellent. So you'll produce 3 of those lockers, and then we'll be... Just, there's nothing that's going to stop us at that point. I wonder if you could cheat a little. Because I remember before, when I was constructing one item, like say a table, and I just quickly, as he was making it, I switched it to something else, it would create that item. So one could potentially use that to produce like a high, you know, a very good item for very little. Like, I think what I'm going to try and do here is, once the third one is being constructed, I'm going to quickly switch it over to the power stamper and see if he creates a power stamper. However... It could be that that's what bugged out my mineshaft here, which caused the module to be unusable. That actually is quite probable. So the question is, do I really want to waste the materials in an experiment like that? Considering I usually don't exploit bugs, even if I'm aware of them, I think I'm going to say no to that. Damn. Speaking of bugs, get away, get out of here, you damn beetles. I should really clear away all this. There we go. I'll let somebody clear that out at some point here. Now, I have way too many assignments for how many overseers I have, but then again, that doesn't matter too much right now. I should probably get another overseer's house while I'm at it. Because why not? Actually, have we met the overseer limit right now? No, actually we have, not even remotely. I mean, we're still waiting on overseers to get shipped out here. I'm guessing 50 would be the limit though, so let's see here. What's my absolute limit for here? Oh, I'm waiting for that. Aw. Awkward. For whatever reason, that painting isn't working. Could be they just haven't built it yet. Which, of course, could be a case of having too many assignments. Let me actually cancel. Let me cancel a whole bunch of jobs here and see if that will help them get those ones done. Like, this is a nice job to do, but it's really just... something I did on a wanted to do on a whim, so let's cancel all that. And oddly enough, the assignments went up rather than going down. Huh. Okay, that's just awkward. Not sure what kind of building they were trying to construct there, but let me cancel that. Hopefully it wasn't the mine I just canceled. No, it was definitely not the mine. Something was really screwy there, that's for sure, though. Alright, so really all we need is another migration wave, which should be massive, considering the cap we have raised. Did they create the second rifle locker yet? No, they still have not. They sure love taking their sweet-ass time, that is for damn sure. This one was placed, though, so the lucky crew is someone who's not actually named. Let's go ahead and assign the laden rifles. Let's look around at my guys and see if they're actually wielding them or not. Well, we have can't actually notice any yet, but hey, hopefully they will eventually be blasting laser rifles at our enemies. For now, though, it is what it is. So again, it's mostly a lot of waiting. Of course, the main reason why I started recording this when I did, rather than waiting a bit longer to collect more items, was because of the whole, what the hell, grimoire thing. 5 coal. And yeah, it says coal, but what it means is charcoal. Because coal we have plenty of, or should have plenty of. Somewhat. Let me switch you back to here. Or the deep vein, yeah. Back to the deep vein for you. Because although sulfur is nice, I already have a mine specifically for that. I also have a lot of chalk. Why did I build this mine up here again? What was I trying to accomplish? I think it was copper, wasn't it? I think that's what I was trying to accomplish. Looks like they're finally getting around to building it. So that's good. Also, we have a ton of coal over here, looks like. Oh, yeah. Well, not a ton. But we do have coal. Now they're trying to haul it off, but they're just not creating enough wine. We have stacks of beer. Yeah, we have a semi-decent amount. And again, they still haven't made this. I'm not sure it's because I did actually tell them to make it. I'm pretty sure I did. Yeah, that one requires the, we have most of that except for the reactive catalyst. That's going to be the big beastie. Of course, this is all made and ready to go here. For that, we need the steam compressors, which I'll have to make. We have almost everything, I think. The spring-loaded power cores, so we need 2 of those, yes. And then we're good to go. We have our steam knights, so I can still see us getting this done here pretty quickly. Also, there's a diplomatic tour. Oh, our relations with the Republic improved. Fantastic. We persuaded them with our lovely assorted amounts of tea and such. Good. The second locker was produced. Who got it? You get it. This guy did. They just haven't actually built it yet because, you know, sleeping. Diplomacy points for old. Don't care. Don't care. Moving on. Let's take a look at this thing here now because they're actually producing now. So it looks like it should produce faster than it was previously. Let's see. So he placed the planks, and we just need to get the stones, which we have, like, everywhere. So hopefully it won't be taking too long. And they also have everything they need to build the third laden rifle locker. Then we don't have to worry about them wasting any more ammo for when I actually build the gun. The one thing I wonder is, do I actually need the gun? Prototype Steam Knight. Oh! Oh, snap. And then that happened. And then that happened. Wow. Wow, game. You are a bastard. So, let's see how much progress we lost. God damn. That is unfortunate. I blame the cultists. Yep, it's all those damn beer cultists. Totally all the fault belongs to them. So, let's see how far back we just got chucked. God damn. Ha-ha! I'm so excited! Ha-ha! Yeah, I don't think we need the rifle. I mean, at least it doesn't say we need to build the rifle, so we might not actually even need the full metal jackets. It could be that we build the Steam Knight and all he can do is punch things until we actually give him a weapon. I honestly am not sure. Perhaps we have to assign him his own barracks or something. Again, not really sure. Never built one. The requirements are a little ridiculous. So, dear God, hurry up, please. You're killing me. You're killing me! Ugh. Sigh. Sigh. Well, time to take a nap. I suggest you make a sandwich. Maybe take a bathroom break. Whatever. You know. I'll just wait here and take a nap, I guess. Might as well. There we go. So, how screwed are we? 0 out of 3 rifles have been produced. I am so excited about that, you don't even know. So, we lost a pretty decent amount of progress, which is a shame. Let's see if I even used this yet. I did write the flattery, I think. Yes, I did. So, basically, we got a lot more time to wait here. So, once again, I'm probably going to call this here. Wait until we have pretty much all the rifles produced, everyone's equipped, and we have enough resources to produce the Steam Knight, and that will continue from there. And then maybe, hopefully next episode, we can wrap this up. And I may also produce another Overseer's House just to get that done. Let me also get rid of this. Alright, that should be good. Till next time. Alrighty then. Good day, and I guess bad news, everybody. Silver Dragon here, coming at you with some more Clockwork Empires. As I said I would once again, I have let several additional days go by. We're already on day 114, I believe. We last left off at about day 109, I believe, if I'm not mistaken. And I managed to get one of the parts made. We actually did get the helmet, so we have the prototype Steam Helmet. But we're left with a bit of a problem. Other than the Steam Helmet, I'm pretty much good on everything else, except let me click this damn thing if it lets me. Because we have the helmet. I don't know if we have the chassis. God knows how much of a pain in the ass it would give me to get the chassis. Let's take a look here. Can I even make the chassis in here? Oh, I can. It just requires one steel plate, which is never going to happen in a million years. So, the main problem. Once again, the workshop, or the metalsmith, is broken. So, we are completely unable to make steel. I've waited, you know, I've made more iron, because the stockpile list is fucked up, and it's totally full of shit. So, what it says we have, we don't have, so I made more iron, I definitely have enough chalk, I definitely have enough coal, but they refuse to make even a single batch of 5 steel ingots. Like, I've been waiting and waiting for you don't even know how long. I've spent, like, the last 3 or 4 hours with it in the background, kind of, you know, just waiting for it to complete some of this stuff. Because in order to make the... Let me go over here. In order to make the 2 items that we need here, the spring-loaded power cores, we require Yeah, five brass cogs. Bullshit, we have five brass cogs. They're over here. We have enough brass cogs to drown in, almost. At least we used to. Apparently now we need more, but that's not really the big issue. The big issue is we need four steam compressors. Now, each steam compressor requires three steel ingots and two copper. Now, the copper took forever and it to get in and of itself, but I actually do have enough. The issue then comes with the steel, and believe me, I've asked for caravan after caravan after caravan, and I haven't gotten a single damn steam compressor built in like 3 hours, so it's at the point where I'm pretty much like, okay, screw this, you win game, GG, have a nice day. So, although I really, really did want to end the series by building a steam knight, completing that, like, momentous task, and, you know, basking in that joy, it seems like it's just not going to happen. Now, I did actually get one for, I believe, the Overseers, but, you know, beyond that, it's just not happening. It is just not happening. So, no matter how long I wait, no matter, you know, pretty much no matter what, we're not getting our steam knight. So unfortunately, I'm gonna have to call things here. I'm trying to debate, do I want to... I think I'll link up this video with the last one, and then post them as one episode in the finale, just because I already did record one, and I don't want to be uploading this as just a 3-minute clip, so I'll add this on to the end, I think, and kind of just leave it as is, because dear lord, I am, like... Ugh, you don't even know. I was like, I just tear out my eyes, kind of frustrated with this. I do hope they will eventually patch this game, really, you know, make it something good. We could go to the snow biome, but, you know, there's so many other games out there that really do deserve my attention, and this one has just gotten to the point now where I'm just like, okay. Unless they make significant, significant advances with the game, it's not worth my time anymore. I've got my money's worth, I've enjoyed it for what it was worth. But as it stands right now, this thing actually got working finally for producing a shit ton of copper. So yes, it did work. It did work. I was right. So yes. But yeah. So anyway, thank you very much for everyone who stuck with this series, who enjoyed it while it lasted and all that good stuff. And just, you know, thank you for watching everything overall. So have yourselves a great one, and maybe I will see you once again at some point in time with some more Clockwork Empires. Till then.